Megillus Fareed's metaphorical mask is finally removed, and he emerges from the shadows to stage a massive coup against Gjallarhorn. He's also confronted by not just one, but two ghosts from the past, and it seems like everybody's getting hooked up with the Elia Vinyana system. In this week's amazing episode of Mobile Suit Gundam Iron-Blooded Orphans. This week's episode of IBO is completely perfect on so many different levels. Not only do we finally get that treasured backstory for Megillus Fareed, but we also get to see the return of some very classic characters. Vidar's identity is revealed. We have brand new Gundams, and the stakes have officially been raised, as Megillus Fareed has effectively taken control over Gjallarhorn. He's taken all of the other Seven Stars members and has them in a quarantine, and it looks like he's getting ready to go after Rustal Elion, and he's not going to be able to do this alone. He has his very own group of cronies who are going to be working along with him, who basically just seem like your run-of-the-mill scapegoats. But the reason that Megillus is so freaking proud of his plan is because not only does he have access to a legendary mobile suit known as the Gundam Bile, but this Gundam just so happens to contain the soul of the founder of Gjallarhorn, Agnika Kairu. That's right, things are starting to get a little Evangelion-styled in this Gundam anime series. Where do I even begin with this one? Let's just go ahead and talk about Megillus Fareed's backstory, which now I sympathize with a lot more. Not only was he an orphan himself who grew up in a war-torn setting, very similar to Mikazuki, I might add, but apparently his stepfather was also something of a sexual deviant. The reason that his father was so obsessed with blonde boys is not because of just the way they looked, but simply that was what he was into. There's a scene in this week's episode where they basically just say that Megillus Fareed was basically a sex slave for his stepfather. It's a really disturbing scene. They don't say it outright, but there's a shot of him as a young kid getting out of his father's bed where he looks like he's been severely beaten and his dad is basically there, and it's just does not paint a very nice image. And it's basically sort of like the final straw that broke the camel's back. I think this was the moment when Megillus Fareed cracked and he decided that he was going to reform Gjallarhorn, and he was going to do it in the most over-the-top and ridiculous fashion possible. And that's when he decided to resurrect the Gundam Bile, hook himself up to the Elia Vinyana system, and become one with the founder of Gjallarhorn, the figure which basically molded Megillus into the man that he is today. But his plans aren't going to go that smooth, as when he actually tries to get into the Gundam Bile for the very first time, he is immediately confronted by Vidar, who just crashes down into this mobile suit hangar, and this was the moment where I lost my shit. I'm like, oh my god, this is really happening. They're finally gonna have an epic battle. We get the reveal of Vidar, and big shock, it is Gylio. They could have hit it a lot better by maybe changing the way his voice sounded or not giving us so many obvious cues, but at least it's good to know that it is officially Gylio trying to get his revenge against Megillus Fareed for taking over Gjallarhorn and practically stealing his sister away from him. I especially love how this is very similar to the whole Shar Aznable Garmazabi storyline from the original Mobile Suit Gundam, but what makes this one interesting is that Gylio survived his very first encounter where he was seemingly killed and now has a brand new opportunity to go up against Megillus Fareed, and he's certainly going to have one hell of an advantage in that, because not only is his Gundam just really freaking powerful, but it also contains the brain of Ein from the very first season, the man who was basically fused to his mobile suit. So now basically there is this AI which is based on his brain inside, and this is a mobile suit which is being piloted by two people. And that's what's interesting here. You have Megillus Fareed, whose Gundam Bile has supposedly the soul of the founder of Gjallarhorn. You have Vidar, otherwise known as Gylio, who has the soul of Ein. And then, of course, you have Mikazuki, who's piloting the Gundam Barbatos Lupus Rex, which is basically piloted simply just through him in the Elia Vinyana system. But now it's got me wondering, is someone's soul actually residing within his mobile suit? That'll be an interesting prospect to see, and it also basically opened our eyes to something that we maybe never even thought about before. What I will say is, it is kind of disappointing that we don't get to see, like, a straight-up battle between Gailio and Megillus, because suddenly Mikazuki just shows up after completely tearing up Gjallarhorn's forces and decides to intervene. And at first it seems like he's going to have an extreme advantage, but when you actually get to see that AI version of Ein kick in, basically the Vidar turns into, like, an almost supernatural mobile suit, having the ability to teleport around and be incredibly fast. And now, basically, all three characters are sort of, like, on equal footing. And basically, it ends up turning into a situation where Gailio does have to retreat. But it's a triumphant moment for Megillus, because not only does he have Tekkadan, like, on a freaking choker chain, but now he has access to what is arguably one of the most powerful weapons in the series, and basically just stands over Gjallarhorn triumphantly as he begins his brand new revolution, which I have a feeling is not going to end so nice. And I still feel that there's an even darker motive to what Megillus is planning to do. But damn, guys, this episode was perfect. And it basically is letting us know that we're going full steam ahead to the finale of this series. And man, it's going to kick ass. So what's the rundown on this week's episode of Iron-Blooded Orphans? Words leave me at a time in an episode like this, simply for how incredible it was. Not just from the incredible action and the really cool robots, but like the actual characters themselves, their motivations, and the fact that the title Iron-Blooded Orphans can now basically apply to Megillus Fareed, and I never even thought about that before. The fact that his past is strikingly similar to Mikazuki's, albeit going down a very different path of being owned by a guy who is into fucking kids, it's just really messed up. Again, reaffirming that this series can go to some incredibly mature and dark places. It also makes you sympathize with Megillus just a little bit more. You know, I never really fully trusted him, but seeing what he went through and all the things that he had to endure just to be able to live a comfortable life is disturbing. And the fact that he was basically harboring these thoughts his entire time and just sort of biting and waiting for his moment shows how incredibly dedicated he is to his cause. And that makes him a pretty terrifying figure. I don't think it's really any surprise that Vidar ended up turning out to be Gailio, and the fact that he still looks basically normal aside that he has, like, this scar on his face is honestly kind of surprising, because his cockpit was outright just completely decimated, so I expected him to look a little more, dare I say, zombie-ish? Maybe just a little more messed up, but nah, basically he's still just the same. Just a more hardcore version of Garma Zabi from the original Gundam. But I like the fact that he has the Ein system attached to him. Like, that is so interesting. And I didn't expect that, you know, both him and Megillus were going to end up having the Alaia Vignana system, despite the fact that there was a lot of evidence to this. Like, there was the scene where basically right after the Hoshmall was attacking and going after Tekkadan and was destroyed by Mikazuki's Gundam, Megillus became obsessed with the Alaia Vignana system, and it was only a matter of time before he tried to construct his very own version of that, which seems like it might even be a little more advanced than the ones that are used by Tekkadan, a lot of that having to do with the resources which are at Gjallarhorn's footsteps. And I just cannot wait to see what he's going to do from here, if he's eventually going to stab Tekkadan in the back, if he's just going to use them as sort of like a human meat shield, if they're eventually going to break off, and then we're going to end up having this big three-way war between Megillus' Gjallarhorn, we have Rustall's Gjallarhorn, and then Tekkadan as well. It's just going to be this three-way confrontation of epicness, and I can't wait to see, frankly, how it's going to unfold. This was a great episode right here. I love the design of the Gundam Bile. It's very simple, just basically a white and blue Gundam with these really kick-ass thrusters on its back, and we haven't even really seen what it's fully capable of yet. We're just going to have to wait and see that in action. A nice little teaser to see what this brand new mobile suit is going to be like, the Gundam Vidar with its enhancements with the Ein system. Like I said, it might not be actually his soul. It might just be like this reconstructed form of his brain, which is basically just like a copy of his consciousness, which allows this mobile suit to just go completely all out without, like, wrecking Gailio's body. It's pretty damn disturbing that they actually have that ability to do that while Mikazuki is still constantly sacrificing every single portion of himself just to actually fight against these guys. Just, man, this was a great episode right here. Next week's going to be even crazier. The preview, I think, was a little spoilerish in some of the things that they were showing. Like, it actually showed that Almeria, the young little girl, the sister of Gailio, who's going to supposedly marry Megillus, looks like she's actually been attacked by someone. Like, she's, like, clutching her chest and she's bleeding. So, like, she might have just been attacked by someone. She might have just been shot. I don't know what this is all going to be a part of. But things are definitely just getting insane right now. And I can't wait to see how it's going to wrap up. Guys, this episode was awesome from every single angle. 5 out of 5 from me. If any of you did watch the episode, make sure to tell me what you thought about it in the comment section below. What did you think about this week's incredibly eye-opening episode? Did you like to finally get seeing McGillis's true backstory? Was it really disturbing for you as it was for me? What do you think is going to happen in this big conclusion of the series? Does McGillis have some sort of ulterior motive with using Tekadan? What do you want to see? Make sure to tell me in the comment section below. Thank you guys so much for watching this review. Make sure to subscribe to the channel for everything Gundam anime related. Leave me a comment or two. I'd love to chat with you guys. And if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with all your friends. I'll see you guys next time. And as always, stay dandy, baby.